Okay, ladies and gentlemen, they're going to start coming out of this church fairly soon, I think. Getting close to 12 o'clock. They may go over some since I'm out here, hoping I'll leave. But the Lord wants me out here until they're all gone. So I'm out here, and fortunately the law didn't run me off. They tried to pressure me to leave. And I want you to think about this. If a pastor's got the true love of God in him, okay, think about this. If a pastor's got the true love of God in him, instead of him calling the law on me to try to have me removed on the right of way, okay, he should show the love of God. I got scriptures on my sign, and I preach scriptures while I also expose him and this church, okay? Because if, ladies and gentlemen, let's just be honest with ourselves, okay? If you can go to a church and commit willful sin and have willful sin in your life, such as breaking your husband's heart or your wife's heart after 41 and a half years of marriage and leaving him because she says I caused uncalmness in her life because I wasn't going along and getting along with my son, living in sin, shacking up, having a child out of wedlock with no remorse and no repentance. Okay? That's what it all started over. Okay? So she started coming to this church right away after she left me. And if this preacher or any preacher, ladies and gentlemen, was doing their job properly, okay, a pastor is supposed to put the fear of God in people. If he's not putting the true fear of God in people, he's not doing his job. If he's not preaching the narrow and straight message that Jesus taught, but he's compromising with sin and don't even name sin, okay? The only time they name sin is they say, well, believe and confess your sins and you're saved, okay? Well, you shouldn't sin, but you'll still go to heaven if you do, which is poison, ladies and gentlemen. The Bible don't say that. The Bible says he that commit a sin is of the devil, okay? So I could give you many scriptures. Watch my other videos, okay? I'm truly exhausted being out here, okay? Because I don't like to say it, but I have to. I'm so far on a three-day fast, okay? And I didn't want to come out here, okay? I was hoping to never see this church again. Okay? But God told me at 7 o'clock this morning to come out here and preach in front of this man's church and warn these people. Okay? So that's what I'm doing. Okay? But if a person, you know, it's good for sinners to go to church. But what the pastor's supposed to do is warn them to repent and tell them they have to believe and repent if they want the Lord to come live inside of them and fix their life, okay? You can't continue in sin, okay? And the Bible says without holiness, no one shall see God, okay? Jesus said, many will come up to me on that day and say, Lord, Lord, we've cast demons out in your name. We've healed the sick in your name, done many wonderful works in your name. And he said, I'll tell them, depart from me, you workers of sin or iniquity. I never knew you. Okay? And that's going to happen to a lot of preachers. It's going to happen to a lot of churchgoers, a lot of Sunday school teachers, okay? And a lot of people, okay? Jesus said the way is narrow and straight to heaven, ladies and gentlemen. Okay? I hope you won't be delusional and you'll believe all of God's word. I encourage you to study God's word. Okay? Don't believe everything the preachers tell you. You know, this is a Church of God brand. You got many, many different brands in this country. They all say they preach in the word of God. But we know they can't all be right, right? Okay? Because they preach in different things. Okay? So we need to study the word, okay? Just be honest with yourself. You know that most people that call themselves Christian / saved aren't living holy. Okay? They're not living holy. Yet the Bible says without holiness no one shall see God. So here I am out in front of this church. Okay? And this one, you know, one of the preachers says, I'm glad your wife is divorcing you, which my heart was so broken and is still broken over, okay? And would tell me such a horrible thing, okay? And he'll answer to God for it, okay? But God said, come out here and preach the word to them. They don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear it. They called the law on me, okay? You'll see in one of my other videos, okay? But what would a true Christian do? What would a true preacher do? Well, he'd come over here and talk to me. Well, I'm sorry that man told you, the other pastor told you he was glad your wife is divorcing you. I'm sorry, you feel the way you do about me and this church that I pastor. Okay, but I love you, and you got the right to stand out here. I want to show you this their sign. Okay, and I want you to notice, see the United States flag on that sign right there? See that flag? That represents freedom of speech, ladies and gentlemen. That's what it represents, okay? But these pastors in so many of these churches, okay, they're so hypocritical, okay? Instead of showing the true love of God to me out here, they call the law on me, yet they believe in freedom of speech, right? And got the flag, the stars and stripes all over their sign. And look at that right there, women of the word, okay? Well, they sure wasn't teaching the true word of God to my wife. Because I don't know if she still goes to this church, but I know she was going to it for a good 5 months or more, okay? And they sure wasn't putting the fear of God in her, okay? Because when she first started going to it, she separated from me, which is bad enough. Then after a little over two months, she files for divorce, okay? Think about the people that go to these churches, okay? Okay, they claim to be Christians, okay, and they're hurting people, okay? They're willfully sinning, okay, leaving their husbands, their wives, okay, and hurting people. And that's why the Lord said a hypocrite shall receive greater damnation, ladies and gentlemen, because they turn people away from God, okay? They claim, if I didn't truly know God, ladies and gentlemen, I'd be straight up with you, okay? Because Satan even told me, Ray, why do you even bother serving God when your wife claims to love and serve God and she's treated you like that? And those preachers talk to you like that. But I knew that was Satan talking to me, okay? And I'm gonna live for God no matter what, okay? Okay, come, as they say, come hell or high water, okay? If I'm the only one like Noah, okay, or like Job or people in the Bible, if I'm the only one serving God, then so be it, okay? I'm determined nothing's going to keep me from obeying God and from God's true love, okay? And true love is obeying God, ladies and gentlemen. True love ain't just saying I love God, okay? That's not what true love is. Jesus said, if you love me, you will keep my commandments, okay? That's what Jesus said, okay? It says in the scriptures also, in the book of 1 John, for this is the love of God, that you keep his commandments. Okay? And we're commanded to love one another. Jesus said, love your enemies. Okay? He said, even the world can love those that love them. But a true Christian is supposed to even love their enemies. Pray for them. Okay? Those that use you and persecute you. Okay? So the bottom line is, church is like a social club to a lot of people, okay? It's truly like a social club, okay? It's like if you don't go to their church, okay, it don't matter whether you're right in the Word of God. If your friend or your husband or your wife goes to the church, the majority of the time, they're going to stand up for the one that goes to their church, okay? And have a bias, okay, which the scripture says to have no bias, okay? But they'll have a bias towards the one that goes to their church, okay? over the one that's obeying God and not going to their church, okay? Which is exactly what goes on in this church. I'm a person, I am a firsthand witness of that, okay? With the preachers in this church, okay? But I'm here to, as the Bible says, to reprove and rebuke and exhort, okay? It says that in your Bible in the book of Ephesians, and have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness. Okay? So I'm out here reproving and rebuking this harlot church that tickles people's ears, compromises the word of God. Okay? And you know, this pastor in this church, not only did he do the horrible thing to me, okay, and not preach the whole truth and put the true fear of God in my wife, which is, to me, it's all important, okay? But that would be most important to me, okay? But when he ends his messages, okay, when he ends his messages, he says, everybody close your eyes and bow your head, nobody looking around. Is anybody in here like to give their life to God? Okay. Now think about that, ladies and gentlemen. Think about that. That man knows, it says in the Bible, where Jesus said he that's ashamed of me and of my words, I will be ashamed of him, okay, in the kingdom of heaven. So, but yet he tickles their ears, right? So what he's saying is, okay, they might not raise their hand and want to give their life to God if somebody else is looking around, okay? So do you truly believe that person's really serious with God, okay? If they are ashamed and embarrassed to know that somebody might see them giving their life to God, supposedly. Think about that. Think about that. It's absolutely ridiculous. Okay, but that's another way these pastors, okay, they compromise and seduce the sinners. Okay, you're not supposed to seduce the sinners. You're supposed to preach the word in love to them. Okay, give them the whole truth, okay, and not just the feel-good parts of the scripture, but all of the scripture. So when they do give their life to the Lord, they truly, truly lay surrendering their life to God. They truly ready to lay all their sin down, okay, not some of it, okay, and become truly born again, a different person, as your Bible says, a new person. The old man is dead, okay. But most so-called Christians, most of them in these churches, okay, and it don't matter the brand, okay, some are better than others, okay, but there's poison in 95 at least percent of them, okay, and I know this, okay, I know this. I'll answer to God for saying this, okay, but the bottom line is, okay, we got a lot of unholy so-called Christians in America, okay, and they turning people that is thinking about giving their life to God. They're turning a lot of them away, okay? And then they're making a lot of false converts, okay? And what's gonna happen is when those people stand before God, okay? When those people stand before God one day, they're gonna say, well, Lord, the preacher told me I was saved because I believed in Jesus, confessed my sins and prayed and accepted him. And they're gonna say, yeah, but the preacher deceived you. Yeah, you should have read all the Bible. You should have got into the Bible for yourself. You should have listened to the Holy Spirit telling you, you know, you got to stop sinning. Okay, so they didn't stop sinning. Okay, it's like there's a man that has been messaging me, and I asked him a very honest question yesterday. I said, the church you was going to, did they tell you that you were saved? He said, yes. Okay. Okay, now think about that. They told him he was saved, okay? And the reason the Lord sent him onto my YouTube channel, so he'd been messaging me for a couple weeks, okay? Because he knows that I'm preaching the whole truth, okay? And he's admitted that, okay? But yet they told him he was saved, okay? They didn't tell him he had to lay all his sin down, okay? And he admitted that he still willfully looks at pornography, okay, and masturbates looking at pornography. Okay, that's adultery. That's fornication in his mind. That's a deathly sin according to the Bible. Okay, that would send a person to hell. Okay. So the bottom line is, he admitted he wasn't ready to truly 100% repent, but they made him think he was saved. Okay. And that's what happened to me as a young man. Okay. I was once a hypocrite. Okay. I was deceived just like overwhelming majority of believers / Christians have been deceived. Okay. By plucking, by the preachers unrightly dividing the word of God. Okay. And picking and choosing, okay, the scriptures, okay, to get a big church or to say, hey, man, I led somebody to Jesus. And when they stand before the Lord, the Lord's going to tell him just like he did other people, you go all about the world and you make one more proselyte or conversion of the devil. Okay. In other words, they didn't make a true converted follower of Christ. So anyway, I hope they get out of here soon, but I'm going to keep preaching the word and I'm going to keep the video going. Okay. My breath gets a little shallow because I didn't have anything to drink for 3 days. And I drank a little tiny bit this morning, okay, because I knew I had to come out here and talk a lot, okay? And of course, I've been fasting as well, so my breath gets a little bit short. But the bottom line is, okay, do you want to go to hell? Do you want to deceive yourself, okay? Seriously, do you want to be deceived? You know, Paul says in the Bible there'll be many preachers that's deceived and deceiving others. We need to understand that, ladies and gentlemen. We need to understand that there's a lot of these preachers been deceived. So they deceive others. They preach what they've been taught. Okay? And then there's some preachers that know they tickling people's ears and compromising the word, but they do it anyway. Okay, to grow a big church and to get plenty of money. There's some of those as well. Okay, and I'm here to tell you, I know for a fact there's going to be a lot of preachers in hell. Okay, there's going to be a bunch of them. So God has called me to preach the whole truth and nothing but the truth. And the main problem in America right now, okay, the number one problem, okay, is the so-called church, okay? The false converts that's been deceived at their will, because, you know, we can all study God's word with an open heart and an open mind, okay? And not just dabble in it, and just enough to deceive ourselves, okay? And that's what most believers / Christians do, okay? But we're commanded to study the word of God. It says in the book of 2 Timothy, study the word to show yourself approved unto God. Okay? It didn't just say read. It said study the word to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that needs not be ashamed. Listen now, rightly dividing the word of truth. You know, Satan knows the Bible really, really well, ladies and gentlemen. Okay? And he knows there's a lot of people that are... rightfully have faith in God's word. That's a good thing. Okay. So what he wants to do and what he does and what he's an expert at is deceiving people with the Bible. Okay. That's what he does. Well, if I can't convince them not to believe in Jesus and the Bible, then I'll deceive them with the Bible and make them think that they're a true follower of Christ. Okay, and deceive them when they've never totally surrendered all their heart, mind, soul, and body to God. Okay, and love Him as Jesus said in John 14. Think about this. Jesus said in John chapter 14, he that loves father, mother, brother, I'm sorry, Luke chapter 14. Jesus said in Luke chapter 14, he that loves father, mother, brother, sister, son or daughter, husband or wife, or themselves more than me cannot be my disciple. So think about that. Okay? That means they didn't love him enough, is what Jesus is saying. Okay? There's people love their church more than they love God. okay? Like a lot of these churches, like this church right here, okay? If you look on that sign, if I hold it there long enough, it'll show you that there's a woman preacher this morning, okay? I'll try to keep my phone on to it, okay? Now, the Bible says for the women to keep quiet in the house of God, in the church, okay? I'm not talking about outside the church, okay? It says in the church. It says for her to keep quiet, okay? And if she wants to learn or be taught, let her husband teach her, okay, etc. But they got a woman pastor in this church, okay? That was years ago. You would never see that, ladies and gentlemen. You would never see that. But it's becoming very popular in most churches today, okay? And it's continually getting that way. Just like a lot of them, you know, they've been compromised with sin, and they present a false counterfeit gospel, okay? It's why so many professing Christians are powerless, okay? They don't have the true power of God, but the Holy Spirit represents power. You know, Jesus said, tarry you here until you be endued with power from on high, okay? But that power ain't in most churches, okay? And through the years, it's gotten weaker and weaker because they keep compromising with sin, okay? So the Holy Spirit says, I don't want any part of it. I don't want any part of it. So he's not there, okay? So they have to try to make themselves believe the Holy Spirit's there. So they'll have all different kinds of music, okay? And they'll try to create a good time, okay? To deceive themselves, okay? But the power of God is not truly in most of them, okay? I'm talking about the miracle working power of God, ladies and gentlemen. I'm talking about the power of the Holy Spirit convicting people of their sin, okay? Because the preacher preaches the true word of God and puts the fear of God in them. And the Holy Spirit comes on them and convicts them of the sin in their life. So they get on their knees in tears crying before God in repentance. Very rarely do you see that anymore, ladies and gentlemen. Okay? It's just come up here, pray this prayer, accept and believe, and you save. Okay? And they walk out, and the preacher tells them they got Jesus in their heart now, and they walk out not really knowing it, just like I did in several churches. Okay? When I got into the Bible for myself, I found out I had to surrender everything. I had to lay all my sin down before the Lord would come live inside of me. Okay? And when I did that, okay, don't tell me you can't do it, because I did it. Okay? And when I did it, then the Holy Spirit came flooding into my soul. Okay? Flooding into my soul. I was born of the Spirit. I was baptized in the Holy Spirit, truly born again. If you would have known me, okay, you would have said, man, Ray is a different man. He don't want to go to the movie house no more and watch that garbage. He don't curse anymore. He don't want to smoke marijuana or cigarettes anymore. He don't curse anymore. Okay, he don't have sex outside of marriage anymore. Okay, all those things. And he don't even listen to worldly music anymore because he gave his mind to God, okay, which is the greatest commandment. To love the Lord with all your mind and all your heart, soul, and body. So the bottom line, ladies and gentlemen, I love everyone, okay? I love everyone. I don't want anybody to be deceived by Satan, okay? And so I have to do this work that God has called me to do, okay? And my flesh, quite frankly, don't want to do it, okay? My flesh don't want to do it, okay? But I have to. You know, Jeremiah, he was put in prison. He was put in a dungeon. And he got to the point where he said he wasn't going to say anything else that God told him to say. Okay? Because all the things that God was telling him to say, okay, had to do with judgment. Okay? God judging his people because they were living sinful and evil. Okay? But then he turned right around, Jeremiah. And he says, but it's like a fire shut up in my bones, okay? So that's how the Lord put it inside of him. So he couldn't shut up, okay? So he had to keep preaching what God told him to preach, which was repent, for judgment is at hand, okay? And that's what I have to do, ladies and gentlemen, okay? And you know, your Bible says, For if judgment first begins at the house of God, okay? And if it begins with us first, where shall the sinner and the ungodly appear? Okay? So think about that. That's some serious stuff. So anyway, I'm going to cut this video off and start it again when they start coming out.